Hello again. Well, this weekend was supposed to be another motorhome weekend. We were supposed to be going up to Daventry with Nikki to attend a conference, or she was going to attend a conference up there for her work, but unfortunately she's not well. So we've had to scrub that, and we're not going away in the motorhome this weekend. But because it's such nice weather, I've come down to the river to have the first trip of the year in the kayak. I think we're just going to, or I, because Nikki's still at home, not feeling too good, I'm just going to head up to the lock and back, I think, and maybe have a cup of tea up there. Getting in. Still, seem to have managed it all right today. Well, it's clouded over now. Quite sunny earlier on. Quite clear again later. But still, there's less chance of getting sunburn. I've got my hat. I think there's a hat at the bottom of the boat somewhere. Well, just tell you a little bit about these kayaks. This kayak, as I said before, it's not with me. We were on holiday years ago down in the Loo, visiting some friends down there, and they had some of these sit on top kayaks that they used around the river estuary there. I think he's had a go in one of them, quite the end of the fancy to be honest, but walk around instead. She loved it, and I bought a couple of them off eBay for us. Just cheap Chinese copies of the kayaks. Mine is a rather large one than Nicky's. Pretty good for this sort of thing. Just creeping about up and down the river. Spurt there. There might be a little bit of wind noise because it is quite breezy today. I've got a little sail with me, right, give that a go later. Wind's blowing against me. Swans about on the river. Can't see any. It's blowing me into the air. It's the side here. Probably someone will criticise my paddling technique, but let's hope it's very good. It really is quite windy. Behind me, you should be able to see the remains of the old railway bridge there. Came across the river. So this stretch of river can get a bit busy in the nice weather, but looks like I've pretty much got it to myself today because I guess it's a Friday and everyone else is at work. Probably tomorrow there'll be a fair few motor cruisers coming up and down this section. River's still quite high, had a fair bit of high river levels over the last couple of months. I guess it's going to start going down now. The warmer weather does seem to be here. It's been good for the ducks, I guess. You can see how the river river levels are by the position of this tree, look. Let's go over and have a bit of a look at it. This tree is usually on the bank. River levels do get much higher, of course. I mean, the causeway at Erith isn't flooded. But yeah, this tree has little ducks sitting there, look. So we won't disturb them, we'll edge around it a bit. Yeah. So, really, that's the riverbank just off to our left there. And all that left sort of from here onwards is a flooded field. So we won't go over there just in case we get stuck. Get stuck when I'm on my own. So what I really want to do is to work out a way of taking these kayaks with us when we go away in the motorhome. The motorhome that we've got hasn't got roof bars, and I don't particularly want to drill into the roof of a dry van that's 27 years old. That seems like tempting fate. I have seen the things where you can carry them upright on the back. There are doors on the back, so again, that doesn't seem like the best idea. So I think what I'm going to do is keep my eye out for some sort of trailer. We haven't really got the space at home to store a trailer, but I could store it down at the marina, I suppose, with the kayaks. So that might be one way forward, but it would definitely be good to take the kayaks with us when we go away in the motorhome sometimes. Definitely nice to be back on the river again. Now there's often a swan around this corner that sometimes gets a little bit punchy about you going past him. I can't see him today. Hope he made it through the winter. He was quite a character sometimes. And being nesting season, I imagine he'd probably be at his most defensive. Also sometimes see seals up here. They can get up this far because it's still tidal up here. But they get all the way into St Ives sometimes and quite often have their pups on the river. Haven't seen a seal today, but you never know. Might see one before the day's out, I suppose. Always nice. First time we come out, one was quite curious and kept following the kayak and even laid his head on the back there, which was a little alarming, but quite nice in a way. Of course, you mustn't really interfere with them or feed them or anything, so didn't really encourage it, but it was just a curious sort of animal. Well, I suppose it was probably a she, to be honest. She was just a curious seal, I suppose. Coming up to the I'm not sure that's actually open for navigation for motor cruisers. Everything looks pretty wide open. Don't actually know, to be honest, whether you'd be allowed to go through there or not in your big motor cruiser. But it doesn't affect the kayaks, of course, because we go out on the bank and round. I'm going to land up here somewhere. Let's see where the least boggy bit is to land. Might be a bit waterlogged over here in the usual place. We'll have a look. We'll have a cup of tea somewhere, haven't we? I think if we come up in this little corner here, we should be okay. messy here. Right, let's get the kettle on. Mess. Good thought of that. I think there's still some life in the lighter after sitting in the shed all winter. Yep, that's lit. Oh well, look, here's a fella about to actually go through the log, so that answers the question as to whether you're allowed to do it in this state of the river or not. There you go. Facilities to do that, so always make sure you're fully prepared for any eventuality where you may need some tea. I've also got some crisps that I brought from the marina shop. They're chili and lime crisps. It's perfect with beer, but tea as well. After all, what isn't perfect with tea? Actually, not sure I recommend those chili and lime crisps, especially not with tea. Might have been a step too far, that. Anyhow, I don't know if you can hear the sort of constant whiny, rumbly noise in the background. That's the conveyor for the gravel from the gravel pits on the other side of the river running across and to the other gravel pits on the other side. Don't hear that, of course, at a weekend, but it's obviously a working day today, so they've got it running. While I was having tea, the weather's got a bit more overcast, and if anything, the wind's got a bit stronger, so I'm thinking I might even be able to sail some of the way back. So I'm sail handy in the back of the boat, so I'm ready to give it a shot. And let's see if I can get back in without getting a soaking or getting covered in mud. I tell you, well, behind me here is the sail. Get it out. So, just unfolds like this. Stuck away in the shed for a while, so it seems to have lost. It seems to have lost one of the clippy things. Never mind, we can cope with that by tying it on. I'll have to look for that later on. That's a rather a shame. Never mind, I can get round it by, for the moment, by tying it on. Just tie it with a fairly slippy knot so I can re-sit in a panic if I have to. Right, let's give it a shot. Well, now I've got round the corner, the wind has dropped again, so back to paddling, I'm afraid. But that's good, I suppose. Yeah, not a bad first trip out, I think. Especially since there was tea. Well, it's about quarter to four now, and got that sort of very calm early evening sort of atmosphere going on. It's carried over quite a bit. That's not too bad. Certainly a very pleasant way to spend a day off work, even if we didn't get to go away in the motorhome. Not sure Daventry would be my first choice to go away to anyway. Although it might have been very nice, I don't know. It might be a terrible slur on the town of Daventry. Anyway, it's been a nice day here, so it's all good, I guess. Hope Nicky's feeling better when I get back. Maybe stop off at the shop and get something nice for dinner. No, there's some chicken. Rather muddy getting off there at the bank, so a bit of washing to do when I get back. Something around here is a bit smelly as well. Maybe some cow poo in the boat somewhere. Maybe on my trousers or on my shoes. Still, that's all part of fun, isn't it? So there you go. If you think Cambridgeshire countryside and the fens are a bit boring, maybe the way to see them is from the rivers and the watercourses on a boat. Hopefully, if you haven't been out on the river in a boat, you can see how nice it can be, really, even though the weather's not that sunny. That's all for now. If you enjoyed it, press like, subscribe if you want to see some more, and ring the bell to be notified when we upload something new.